I see that the sky was added, the tree was added into the sky when it was still wet, so it's pushed up the paint around the edge.
Mm-hmm.
And you've got the sort of intermingling of colour.
Mm-hmm. Has this been restored? Has this been re-varnished?
It does have a varnish layer on it.
And just the colours really jump out.
It's quite vivid, isn't it?
Yeah.
The blue sky and the
white. Yeah.
This is much softer, so it's more green.
That's right.
Yeah.
So initially I thought, well, it has a dull tone to it, simply because it has been varnished with a yellowed varnish, and that would cover up maybe the prominence of the colours,
Certainly play a role, but actually this also has, it's quite a good comparison, because it also has a yellow varnish, so it's not the whole story.
No.
You see the imprints of the
cans and that's something that's really nice to compare with the other one. Because this is, you can see that this is done in the here in the green paint when it was still wet.
Mm.
And if we compare it with this painting, with this one it's been made in the white on the layer before the colour was applied. So you can see, for example, here, it's very clever. Somebody has made this weave imprint in the white impasto on the paint, and then applied the colour on top, so the green is collected in the depths.
Mm-hmm. On a real Van Gogh, the imprint of another canvas would have only happened by accident. On this one, it had been done deliberately. It was a damning piece of evidence.
It looks so calculated in the way it's done.
Right.
It's definitely done with an intent of to imitate
or
deceiving. Yeah.
Of deceiving.
Yeah.
So, in your opinion, it's a forgery. Absolutely, without a doubt.
Yes, I think it's so interesting because it's such a clear example of someone that knew exactly what a Van Gogh looked like and has imitated the appearance at the surface, but using a completely different technique in terms of build-up of layers and application of colour.
And how good a forgery is it?
I think it's very clever.
In terms of forgeries in general? Yeah?
I think it's extremely clever. It's somebody that really knew how Van Gogh painted and what exactly, even what happened to his paintings afterwards with this weave imprint and very specific details.
Well, an extremely clever forgery. another question we had was, what is this painting worth to you? Do you want to buy it? Would you be interested in acquiring it? No business here.
Well, a real work might be fun to have in the collection. It's a very interesting kind of affair, and it certainly has a strong documentary value for Van Gogh research.
Mm-hmm.
So it might be interesting for us to have a work.
But we were not ready to give in yet. For an hour and a half, we tried to get them to admit some possibility, any possibility, that they might be mistaken. But every straw we grasped at was snatched away. They were very convincing. Even then, the ordeal wasn't over. Annette Tellegen had made it to the museum to see F614 for herself.
Yeah. Oh, you might cut that out.
From the moment she saw it, she too had no doubt it was fake, styled on another of Van Gogh's cypresses, F613.
The original painting, this is, to say, the color of green is rather dull.
Yes.
And here it is intense, and everywhere is the same heavy touch in here, what maybe Claude should don't exactly know what is meant. And this, though the lines go this direction, it is heavy, and it comes in a way, it is dull and heavy. And here, this, if you see the also the mountains here, they are undulating.
Ha 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 ha!
like I don't feel anymore.
Yeah.
Feeling is gone. No, actually, I have a different kind of hope now.
What do you hope for?
If we're going to sell this painting, I don't want to sell it thinking, oh, it's a fake, and all these experts have said, this is why it's inferior, this is why it looks like a forgery. I want to sell it saying, this is a really terrific painting, even the image, I want to discover some of the beauty in it that I saw at first.
I guess I've had it in my possession for all that time. Mm. I've seen that. To me, that's not what's most important about it. I like when things can confuse, you know, the elite, when it takes them for a ride. It just shows you that everything is pretty relative, you know? That people hunt for the name of a home in such a, you know, in a mad way to chase after a name, when in fact it's not about the name. It's about the idea behind the painting itself. In the end, it's really not important who painted it. Even in our case, does it matter who made that painting?
No, I don't think I'm following you anymore.
Ah, have some more?
Yeah, I think I need
something. That's the way the stomach rumbles. That's the way the bee bumbles. That's the way the needle pricks. That's the way the glue sticks. That's the way the potato mashes. That's the way the pan flashes. That's the way the market crashes. That's the way the whip lashes. That's the way the teeth smashes. That's the way the gravy stains. That's the way the moon.